Tears of pain and agony stream down the cheeks of Konsi Apio as she stands on clutches in front of her young sons. Her pain is caused by a gunshot wound that she sustained on the 15th of January 2021 while returning from buying merchandise in Kotido District.
RDC Kotido. Ordering.
RDC Kotido ordered the soldiers to shoot at our vehicle. Then he told his driver to take us to Kotido Hospital.
For 9 years before the COVID-19 lockdown, Konsi Apio was a boda-boda rider in Gulu City. But when President Yoweri Museveni announced a ban on motorcyclists from carrying passengers, she opted to buy merchandise from the neighboring villages using a cargo truck. Konsi Apio alleges that the UPDF security bodyguards of the former Kotido RDC, Logiro Peter, fired bullets at their cargo vehicle, which shattered the tibia and fibula bones on her left leg. Her leg is now rotting.
The screws in her legs are falling off. She's keeping them now in a tiny piece of paper, as she hopes that somebody can get to her and give money so that she can go back for further surgery. If not, her leg will be amputated.
Today, as she shows us her medical and x-ray documents, Konsi Apio says the RDC initially took her for treatment at Kotido General Hospital, where she was further transferred to Kumi Orthopedic Center for surgery, with the costs being catered by the RDC.
Then he told me that he has already spent a lot of money for my treatment and he cannot pay the treatment costs anymore.
But unfortunately, the RDC failed to complete the payment for her final surgery.
But I don't have any means of getting the money required for surgery.
By August 2021, Dr. John Ekure, the orthopedic surgeon at Kumi Orthopedic Center, called for well-wishers to financially support Konsi Apio. At this point, her disability was estimated at 50%.
Because our work was riding border border, then if her leg has been cut off, there's no way she can survive. So it's a humble request. Even the voluntary people who think that they can support her or the government will be very great.
However, when I contacted the former Kotido RDC, Logiro Peter, he strongly disagreed that he ordered the UPDF bodyguards to shoot at the vehicle that Konsi Apio was traveling in.
I was a commissioner and it was indeed a government vehicle. Where the soldiers were seated, and there were many officials in the vehicle. But because it is a distinct number plate, a distinct title, now for her, that's all she knows. They went to court, and later on, appeal was suing the attorney general, was suing the minister of defense. What we are aware about all this, but my work, my contract ended, I am in my village.
The former Kotido RDC father claims that he did not pay for the treatment and surgery of Konsi Apio.
But if you look at those payments, it doesn't bear my name. That I'm the one where they paid the hospital. It was not, I have never paid any money.
He was retired, so Logiro Peter is no longer a commissioner. Konsi Apio is heartbroken, devastated, in pain, and financially in a dire situation.
Her main plea is that the office of the president can get in touch with her and support financially so that she can go and get further surgery and treatment and is able to get back on her feet and work to support her family. I am Joseph Omagor here in Ngai, Oyam District.